We have an Arduino Dua Milinova for creating the signal. 5 volts, going to the breadboard. Ground, also going to the breadboard. Pin 9, that has the PWM signal, also to breadboard. From there, directly going into the probe, which has its ground shared with the rest of the circuit. Finally, a potentiometer for controlling the duty cycle of the signal. It gets 5 volt and ground from the breadboard. And the wiper is connected directly to A0 on the Arduino. Let's hop into the Arduino IDE and look at the code. In the setup, the A0 pin is set to be an input for reading the potentiometer's wiper value later. Pin 9 is made an output, ready to output PWM for us. This is the main loop and will be executed continuously. First, we will read the value of the potentiometer's wiper on pin A0. Arduino's analog read can go to 1023. Analog write, which is PWM, only goes to 255. So we need to divide by 4. Finally, write this new value to pin 9, which can do PWM. This is a close-up of my oscilloscope. When we turn the potentiometer, we can see the duty cycle of the PWM signal change, which is perfect for us. We set it at 50% for now. A closer look at the oscilloscope, because my webcam can't handle it that good. We can see here that the signal is about 5 volts, top to bottom. The width of the signal is 2 milliseconds, making this a 500 Hz signal. So we have this PWM signal, and now we want to look at its average value. We will do that by having the signal charge and discharge a capacitor, which takes time. And that signal will have to go through a resistor, so it will take even more time. Like drinking a straw to empty a bucket, that takes time. We will find the right size of straw and bucket for this circuit. I start with low values, like this 470 picofarad capacitor. And this 4.7 kilo ohm resistor. The capacitor needs a ground to stand off, of course. This jumper wire goes to the probe number 2 on the oscilloscope. It really does not want to go into the board. That probe also needs a ground. The second signal looks a lot like the first, a bit smoother perhaps. Now let's make the resistor 10 times as big, 47 kilo ohms. And do the same with the capacitor, 4.7 microfarad. This makes about 100 times slower signal. It is looking a lot smoother, but not even close to what we want. So 10 times the values for both of them, again. Resistor to 470 kilo ohms, nearing the limit of what I have in stock. And 47 microfarad on the capacitor. I think we nailed it. Maybe a tenth of a volt, a wobble. Let's back off a bit and try a lower value resistor, the 47 kilo ohms one, and see what we get. Nope, that's too much voltage swing for my tastes. Back in with the 470 kilo ohms resistor. Time to test out other duty cycles. That's what we added the potentiometer for, after all. Look at that. The voltage now goes up and down with the PWM duty cycle. It's beautiful. We will do a short demonstration with the circuit outputting a 1 Hz sine signal, using this code. Afterwards, we will return to the old code. As you can see, the signal is very smooth. That's it for now. Thank you for watching.